birth.
You know, I've had a musical love affair with Ireland. Ever since I first heard John McCormick sing The Rose of Tralee on my father's gramophone. And that's more years gone than I really care to reckon. But I like to think that this affection is reciprocated. And I suppose it is, too, when you think of all the marvelous songs that Ireland has given me, and the world, too, for that matter, and how this wonderful material has enhanced or advanced what I loosely call my career. Now, this program is conceived to bring you again some of this material and to sort of depict in part the background from whence it came.
There's something in you Irish. Will you tell me where you get those Irish eyes?
Tá sé ráite go rág imir ceirín tír seo fado gan de bhuiin acu ach an snáthar an ghrím. A thug siad rud a cinnt eile leo, rud a cinnt nach bhéití iompar na go dláha. Thug siad óráin agus ceolam bhaile leo ina gcruithe. Rinne na himircí seo a mealach sáil go London agus Liverpool, Boston agus New York, áit a réamh siad agus a bhuanna siad tealaí. A measc na n-eoraithe seo bhí daoine ar nós Jack Lennon agus Peter Morrissey as Baile Ó Clia, John Christopher Lydon as Tuam agus Peggy Sweeney as Muio. Spreagach an diaspora gaelach seo gohan an nua san nidegu agus fichu ís a darhoch seal an fapheol. Ach cain tionchar a bhí ag a nairach gaelach ar na ceolturi seo. Cain éfacht a bhí ag a gúlra éirnach ar óraní ar nós John Lydon, Morrissey agus Marr, Dusty Springfield, John Lennon, nó na dreharach i Gallagher, maastro daigur a éfacht ar behegafu. Má tá pátrún le sonrúin seo is fiú breanthú ar ó hús leis an géad fia réal a réimse an fapheol Bing Crosby.
I think in many ways my Uncle Bing was a very typical story of an Irish immigrant family. He was the fourth of seven children of my grandparents, Katie Harrigan, whose family had emigrated from West Cork in around 1870 or 1871. And moved to Nova Scotia initially and then settled in Stillwater, Minnesota, where my grandmother was born in about 1873. My grandparents met in a choir, so they met singing. They were both excellent singers. My grandfather also played the banjo, and they had a very large family of seven children, of which my father, Ted Crosby, was the third, and his brother, Harry, who later became well known as Bing, was the fourth. When he was about 4 years old, before he'd learned to read, he became fascinated by a local comic strip that appeared in the Sunday papers in Spokane called the Bingville Bugle. So he was constantly pestering his older brothers who could read. As soon as the Sunday paper got there, he wanted to be read the comic strip, the Bingville Bugle. So his brothers started calling him Bingville. And within a short time, it was shortened to Bing. And that was by the age of 5 or 6, he was Bing Crosby, and he was never anything else to anyone except his mother, who never called him that. She always called him Harry.
Togach Bing Crosby a gorsanach caitiligach éirinach is Spokane, baile beag an iar húsgeart verico.
I'll take you home again, Kathleen.
Dás Bing suas a dealach ceolwar agus tháinig muintir Crosby le chéile cholíthe chun éisteach le cairníní nó chun óráin a chana ó bhilioga ceol. Bhí siar óráníthe agus cumadóirí éirinacha le cleisteal go minic ag na hianta síimsíochta sin.
An sáis áráin a bhí acha na áráin Thomas Moore dúirt sé Gurbe, believe me of all those endearing young charms on Tauron Ernak Abansa Lena Wahar Hain.
It's not a good rean the hairn the in ingo Bing Crosby. I mean Krishia got in a ruined than Kill's son. Oxwinic Shear, Swinish Thomas Moore better. you know, and hear the singer-songwriter better, Honey Rhea Vasantirsha. Believe me in all these endearing young charms, the last rose of summer has sorrow thy young days shaded, the minstrel boy. You know, the Thomas More, on a voor in America, especially on a voor, had the lace curtain Irish.
When they were growing up, they were exposed to Irish music in a big way. I mean, obviously, the popular Irish songs of the day, of course, Uncle Bing often said the most influential singer on him in his formative years was the great Irish tenor John McCormick. He knew all of John McCormick's material, things like Mother Machree and Ireland, Mother Ireland.
So we always had music in the house. We had the phonograph, and we had McCormick, John McCormick, and we had all the singers of that period. And then later on, of course, all the Jolson. And I think whatever style I use is a combination of John McCormick, all the ballad singers, and Al Jolson.
For Bing Crosby, tús le na gairim cool is Spokane le grúpa dar venim the musical leaders a bhí bunny ag a chara Al Rinker. A bhóvar na blian an lídeag fiche cúig hua Crosby agus Rinker go Los Angeles le chéile agus iad a gira gola bhaim ar gnó na siimsiachta. Tí bhaisteid de thí seachtane bhí sé de casa ar Stáitsí Vaudeville le grúpa dar venim the Rhythm Boys. Ag fonadóireach sna picturlana agus áirclana céna in ar chas glúnta da haibhóirí Vaudeville gweil vericána chrúmpa.
Tá sé fíorar á go bhfuil sais indelible thumprint fág ag muintir na tíir seo ar Fulbert an Ceolson in America. Minstrelry, Vaudeville, Tosanlú Broadway, George M. Cohn, Harrigan and Hart, Víodar Ann, Ledini Cosúla, Irving Berlin, Chauncey Alcott, Iad Son or Fad. Tá dlúvint ag ceoltóirí hagan ón tír seo, agus hánig ón tír seo an chéad lá riamh ar Fulbert Ceol America.
Look out! You ready for this? Who's that coming down the thoroughfare? The sunshine flashing on his ring. Bowing left and right and here and there.
You're delightful.
Just floating. That's Chester, the trombone king. He gets his shirt straight from Paris, cigarettes from the night.
A goalie, Thomas Gornow. Agus tagin popular music culture son fehuish deir amach asan mascon son. Na hamidet mahamidet cordon kesht, unfaded, an kiol grelach no kiol tradition in the hidden. Fele a aim shu in san melting pot son in san mascon, mascon an futa son. Tashi ane yakar. Ta big hinte gwil shiam. Ta kiol born the horpe. Mar lór chid, mar éan le ceol dúf, nó ceol gorm na Hafrica, mar lór, é lór anad, an pop ceol, an rock ceol, an blues, agus a le héad.
Lennox Avenue is known for doing a lowdown, but you'll find they're not alone in doing a lowdown. Fifth Avenue's learning how they had to fall. Fifth Avenue does it now. That's not all, whenever the folks hire to that mean lowdown, now there's no lowdown lower than that.
With the Rhythm Boys and with Bing in his early days, he really started out as a jazz singer. And early in his soloist career, he was more known as a jazz singer than anything else. And in fact, he had met Louis Armstrong in 1926 when they were both unknowns in a speakeasy illegal liquor club in Chicago during Prohibition. And they became lifelong friends. And in fact, late in his life, someone asked Louis Armstrong as the godfather of jazz, you know, who's the greatest jazz singer you've ever heard? And without hesitation, Lewis said, well, Bing Crosby, of course. He's the greatest jazz singer ever.
So you can lay your dough down when they go low down. The dough, low down, lower than that.
His real break came in the fall of 1931, in September, when he was featured on a national radio program on CBS. I think the show was entitled 15 Minutes with Bing Crosby. And he sang two songs or three, and the next morning CBS was flooded with telegrams about this new singer that was on, and can we hear more of him, etc.
Here in your arms, I can't remain. So let me kiss you once again. Soon we must say.
Lelín na níidag tíochadí, dás cáil Bing Crosby de réir mar wánse clúamachs na scónáin agus ar an rádio. Bhí gá Crosby ar cheánde na gohanna bus sa aantar daun, agus lelín an ama seo, dág sé stíl snag chiol na bichadí tí fiardó agus sasa seag farbert stíl dachad féin ar a dugan muid crúning sa látáinu bán. Bhí tionchar a chiol a óge ar an stíl óraníchta seo, ach ag an am céna bhí sé go thomláin difriúil ó anadóireacht na teanóir gaelacha ar nós John McCormack.
He would have heard some of those early recordings of John McCormack and positioned himself by the time he became a commercial success in contrast to that, because the Irish tenor at the time was considered very much an urban, domesticated, sometimes even emasculated version of an Irishman, which made him safe for the parlor and safe for non-Irish Americans. But Bing brought that lower pitch, that deeper level, with the same vibrato as the Irish tenor, but in such a way that people felt welcomed when they listened to him. And he wasn't so much on a stage and far away, the way the early shouters were and the way that Irish tenors like John McCormack were.
Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me.
Nir hosi Bing Crosby amach ag canabha profesiúnta, bhíach aránthe a bra ar loidrocht an glórtha agus fuinneamh an glórtha. Ach díreach nir a bhí Crosby ag teacht chun tosig, níidag fhéas a cuaig fhéas a sé, tháinig na micrófóin chun tosig agus bhíadar in núsáid gurmach a ceol agus a halí rinca agus mar sin. Agus there on microphone Gohanawa the glor August the Farsantucht Crosby.
Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me.
Stille Gonstrus steel on a farsanta, agus vishe on a cholver er fad on size on character of the bainchlen of glor lin ago the chapok on teistor gur chigehain wine of the Crosby ag canna.
I said that I was Flanders part of, but now I'm back to cry my heart out.
Being a baritone, he could sing at a low pitch, and that allowed people to dream that he was singing right in their ear, maybe while he was dancing with them. And he was a huge hit with women that way.
To prove it, you alone I care for. Each night I say a little prayer for just one more chance.
So one of the vocal ornaments that Bing would use is called a mordant, and in a lot of his melodies, you'll hear him, especially the slow melodies, he'll sing something like, da 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 da, like that, and it's the da. That's just a one of the many ornaments that are available to Irish singers in Shannos, right? But he would often put it on the very last note, and that's not something you hear very much in Ireland. He does use it just before that last note as well. So, da da da. This is something totally characteristic of him, and you just don't hear other people singing it. My best guess is that he heard this in his own family. And he also would have heard it in performances sometimes, and from some of the 78s that were brought home, because he didn't grow up in a vacuum.
And now the purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky the little stars climb, always reminding me that we're apart.
Tushdil ornal dirthige, ak ni chlushim johinia, ni chlushim daracho kahan, ni chlushim fiwan Nicholas Toibin, no moira on the gonacha, ego Bing Crosby. Smooth, gentle, agus ak person tagin on hiana, estolim guil nismo wint ege Bing le snag kill na. Oh, will get shadows.
I spend the lonely night dreaming of a song.
Sean Rotherha is alive again and sure no and sort go of Erdina, no, and sort slee and slee and our usider and go. Nor I'm being to a swine of her and the crooners, because it'll have been Crosby, I guess the background the Gaelic, background air and the Crosby there now. Kinte betu a sul gomeach rod egen in sant fuam, be gomeach rian egen in sant fuam, in sant tamber, le chlosant, ac ni feder is in a scrif sias, nor vien to fechan ter cratches ag as quavers as a head, ni leen rod scrita er an bop eid, a winin le sant tamber, an fuam hain, an fuam parson te hain, Hagen our on e. Rod slit or will nis tauch thee, na an faun, no few one wouldn't nis tauch thee na an a fuckle.
It had to be you. Yes, it had to be you. I wandered around, and I finally found somebody who could make me be true, could make me feel blue.
Chur sheshan tús var éire le genre nua, ba crúnar Bing, bhí a glóir fíor wag a hagin am cén a láidir, bhí se in an óran sciupu a chása, a hagin am cén a bhí se ré a chúsach a chása.
Might never be cross or try to be bar.
I think the crooning sound came from the Irish tradition. Creating that level of intimacy, again, is something that is absolutely tied to him and tied to an Irish performance practice, because of sitting next to someone in a, you know, in a living room or in a kitchen, when they say, well, how did that song go? And then they'll say it right in front of you, 2 feet away from you. So Bing Crosby could use this in a microphone as a way of sounding like he's your friend or your lover.
Might never be me. Might never be cross, or try to be
bar. I guess Honick crooners in the year, Tony Bennett, Marchionette, few on Frank Sinatra, Honick in y'all at a number to be dint like Bing in St. John Rashin. I guess Rodida, ni more on Dina Cecile at Anana Ra, Gurkhurder Toos, that la Sean Renu Kyoil.
It had to be you, had to be you. Wonderful you. when you're strolling down the Boreen.
That means the lane.
A friendly brook will sing you this sweet refrain. Cade Mila Falchion slant you to you, and the top of the morning too.
Hi!
When it's early in the A-Rock,
that means the spring.
The birds are glad to see you, and here's what they sing. Cade Mila Falchion slant you to you, and the top of the morning too.
Nu de vlak met de kapoorts de dara koga daunde, ra bing boek vintje gareme. Has bing maar eschem lord en de lochene seal bewoel is de miljoen medicanoch of die poortig se goga, samale agas haar jaar. Thaar, jihaloch, ja weinig. Thaar of in de ouder mischni in dreefse jakker. Ja humple of die ming e fein de scale raha verica. Agus an ish le clú agus cáil baint amachaige, has a séag breanhú ar an áit as a dánig sé, agus a doling lec le an aireacht éiranach.
Smaining sír gudí an áma bhí sais Bing Crosby a gáil a cúrsi ceol in America sais na fehedi túsna trúcadí tarait an Great Depression. Agus bhí na hérnig ag an áma san Dinia Kuiger Imerka, Teresh on Gorta Moor, a Vidar, Vidar in America, Vidar Dolt Suis on Dreamer, Maraderha. And she and Anna Vivi are in Man, Acme, Ernakavi, Alneganamna, the Lace Curtain Irish. Agus on sort soundtrack, a V Igna Dini show, no Dini Kasul, the Bing Crosby. Tura Lura Lura Lura, it's an Irish lullaby.
I think he began to engage in his Irishness when his career was well established, and it then became safe for him to do so because he was in a position of power at that point. He was wealthy, he had put a lot of money into the recording industry, and that was really taking off. So he was able to start reflecting that Irishness in both his performances and in his movie appearances.
It's probably well known even among people in Ireland that for a long time after the Irish wave of immigrants went to America, they were considered second-class citizens. There were signs out that said, no Irish wanted here, Irish stay away, etc.
The image of the sort of drunken fighting Irishman who can't hold a job, that was a very big part of both vaudeville and variety in the 19th century that continued into the 20th century.
This persisted in America for a long time, and I think the real break point, and really, you know, when I think about at when in public persona did Uncle Bing really begin to embrace his Irish heritage, it really broke out in the mid-early 1940s with the film Going My Way.
What's your name?
Father O'Malley. Charles Francis Patrick O'Malley.
Tooraloo-ra-loo-ra.
Sivlian Lidia Kercha Keher, Glock Bing Crosby, Ports Mar Haggart, the Vianoch Gael Vericanoch, Saskonon Going My Way. We are con de war scon on the blianishine, agus war bing agus an tashdod erinoch Barry Fitzgerald, gradam Oscar dogwit portina on.
And when Bing Crosby, the most popular, by far, star in the universe, both as a singer and as a film star by this point, played an Irish Catholic priest, Father Charles Francis Patrick O'Malley, in Going My Way, suddenly, instead of having a stigma to being Irish, it was now cool to be Irish.
Oh, would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a mule?
In some Ashtershin, oh, that the lung organ, Bajor Cove, Igunda Corky, was a town south, hard in Atlantic, Turesh. On Gorta, August Tosnian Far, August A. Tuckel to the Sag, Ubert, more laborer in America, kin to the Quichus Susanthromeda, kin to Fui, you know, Nadio Kaigane, Nadio Shaska, V. JFK, August the Kennedy's attacked, August Dibrig on Rodavir Shul, August Vier Bun, Egan Bing Crosby, in Snaskonoin, August in some Quid Kyol, August in the Hauron, Quidu. Lish on Ashterson. The hug she ahantus. Ifigul, or derho. Dos nahernig. a Viennish, ní éirnig a wán a bhíonta, ach Irish Americans a bhíonta.
Tooraloo-ra-loo-ra, tooraloo-ra-la, tooraloo-ra-loo-ra. Hush, now don't you cry.
Bing Crosby seems very lightweight in the, say, the Paramount films of the 30s. They're nice, but doesn't really have a lot of, doesn't require a lot of acting ability. But then when you see the movies in the 50s, like Country Girl and High Society, then suddenly you realize this guy could actually act. In a way, it's a pity that he didn't have stronger roles earlier, because even Going My Way, you know, there's very little dramatic talent required. But it's what American audiences wanted, and I think Bing Crosby was also playing to this. I mean, I think it's a matter of the studios knew what their audiences wanted. You know, you could argue, say, well, the studio heads are all Jewish. Why do they? But they're good businessmen. They know audiences don't want to see Jewish characters on screen. You seldom find a Jewish character in a Hollywood film of the past, but you find lots of Irish characters.
Bit of old Ireland. Eh?
I think he was bringing out his Irishness for both heritage pride and commercial reasons, because as the Irish went more into the middle class and the upper middle class, they became more visible politically, certainly, absolutely, and in films. And they also had more money, and so they could buy his recordings and support the products that were being pitched on the radio shows that he was doing. And so this is a way for him to unite Irish-American audiences around him, but he clearly was part of the right kind of Irishness by American standards, and particularly by Irish-American Catholic standards. He was celebrating the right kind of Irishness.
I've met some folks who say that I'm a dreamer, and I've no doubt there's truth in what they say.
Kinta the nostalgia áirithe of Winters and Roddy Shaw. Thus, na dini a cuigar imerkes na leanta son vi other howl in America, vi other sit a howl in America, near a vein etalon aon, near a vein, you know, Virgin Atlantic na Ireland, ingas na faic. You know, vi other in America, vi other aon, agus nor gúnsiad a huile, vi other egg, irig, an shanna here a howlu, agus dibrig on go, agus on kyo, agus fuckle na nauran of egg being Crosby, this na dini shin.
And precious things are dreams unto an exile. They take him o'er the land across the sea. Especially when it happens, he's an exile from that dear lovely Isle of Innisfree.
I would argue that Bing was instrumental in establishing the romanticized image of historic Ireland that so many Irish Americans today associate with Ireland. So right at the time when Bing is hitting his stride, all the money to be made is in the image of the weeping mother and Mother McCree and that kind of thing, because it's safe, it's home, and it's rural and intimate in a way that the big American cities of Philadelphia, Boston, and New York are not.
Comach Aurain Erinacha, then Taishin or Tin Panelli Aurain Tractal of Vion, Dilakid Viloga, Kyoi Lucas Marchin, Ags Hui Rantiv, Kernin, Noi ni Winshid Laheran, Ak Winshid La Nagail Snestite, Anthahan, Nagail Vericanic.
V Nemilte, Milte, Nikia the Milte Namaloon Ernig in Santir. Fargano about Bing Crosby. The Higshe, Griff constituency of Mahonson, agus go raibh árán ón constituency son. Sin sais cine commercial a rinne sé, a bhuiling leic leis an rud a tháinig as an tír seo, agus é sníomhisteach a dtí an stíl a bhí aige, agus an stíl sin a chun amach, agus d'oibrigh an am a bhaile leis.
Bhí an meas mór a bhí ag gael veidicánaí ar Bing le feiceáil a díad a hinsir freisin, agus cuireadh 100,000 fáilte a bhaile rudha. Mar bhuaic fuinte a chaidrimh iontach le héirin, thafad Bing ceolchairim dóráin éireannacha in seo i saoire na bliana 1967. Cruailleach an ceolchairim ar fud a dhann, agus bhí sé stiúrthaigh an gealtóir agus an léirithóir mór le rá, Buddy Bregman.
What happened was I met a guy named George O'Reilly, and he said, Bing wants to do a show. Bing said, he said that, I like the idea. Yeah, I said, I want to do kind of a travelogue in a way, but not a travelogue, you know. I want you to be in certain places. And I said, I had an idea about the Guinness Brewery. I tell you, he loved it.
You know, the Guinness Company, whose facilities you see here in the background, has its cultural activities too. This is their choir. I'm certainly glad they chose to sing Believe Me of all these endearing young charms because it's a favorite song of my mother.
Believe me of all those endearing young charms which I gaze on so fondly today.
Up here is being in Ireland with me. That's the Guinness Brewery. I just shot a gigantic situation there with Bing, and so we were watching the playback, and a lot of the people from the brewery were in the film, and Lord Guinness allowed me to use the use the premises. He said, "What are you going to do?" He said, "I want to shoot in the brewery." In the brewery? I said, "Yes. Can you do that?" He said, "Buddy, my name is Guinness."
My name is McNamara, I'm the leader of the band. Although we're few in number, we're the finest in the land. We play at wakes and weddings and at every fancy ball. And when we play at funerals, we play the marching song.
Ní réin agresánach gur thosa sé brenn siúr ar a chud éirecht. Mar a tharlaíonn chuinne lug agus muid gola níos, tosaíonn tú brenn ar náit as a dánach tú béidir agus na rudaí a chuhaimart. Go háirithe in na raic na seascadaí agus Bing in isi na air éist a gomá. Thosa sé díana éréirin agus a túir cuairtaí ar an tír. Agus de réir dealrabh an méid atá ráite ag dtíine chas leis ag an am sin nó béidir na dtíine thuga chomhad leis an tír seo. Gur fíor ghaol a bhí an ar go leor bealaí. Waitha sé ar nós éireneach agus thuig sé an dlú bhainte bhí aige. Agus béidir freisin gur a go leor waigne seán nar thosa sé smaoinú ar a chuid sin siad a dág an tír seo agus iad fíor wacht.
Níor tháinig sé go héireann go dtí 1960 a héireann, si déanach go leor, ach in iad sin bhíodh sé teacht an seo go mbeadh minic a gcimirt galf ag freastal ar Rossy Coppel agus tá sin rudda.
I'll be marching along in the big parade on St. Patrick's Day. I'll be up to me neck in shamrocks as I march along the way. I'll swing that old shillelagh as I wave to each colleen. I'll tilt me ear the better to hear the wearing of the green.
Oh, Bing is beautiful. Bing was lovely, like. Nor if you miss his fast was a gorkig, you know, the being on radio and Tom or Fad. Gok Nullig, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. Natura Lura Luras. They don't, I mean, the Bing Crosby or Gachrod.
Well, have you looked up the Irish blood that's in you?
I tried it a couple of times. I could never find it. You see, my mother's, my grandmother's name was Ahern, and my grandfather's name was Harrigan, of course. H-A-R-R-I-G-A-N spells Harrigan. Divil a man can say a word agin me. Proud of all the Irish blood that's in me.
Bhí an tír seo thar a bocht, agus bhí go leor daoine gimocht mar a bhí riamh an tír seo ar imirce. Agus sílim go rá bhaid níos mú meas ar leithítí Bing Crosby agus níos dearnaíonn sin ar nóid JFK na mar sin de. In san tír seo ná mar hílinn muid fiúan in is, mar go rá na daoine brean a seo mar éirinaí a chua Harsala agus gur aire lo.
Istan gur avan kion fad ag muidir na tír seo ar Bing Crosby. We clasped him to our bosom and said, he is one of ours and we love him. And isn't he a lovely man? And isn't he successful? And look at him there with his pipe. And he's going to the races and he's down the car and he's going to draw the sweepstake ticket. Isn't he fantastic? You know, John F. Kennedy, De Valera, the Pope, Bing.
Agus é gimmer galf sa spáin ar an chearrthú láidéag dí ar a fóvar 1967, héits Bing Crosby go tala agus caillú le taim crié. Mar ocal scoir dúrt sé, that was a great game of golf, fellas.
I'll take you home again, Kathleen.
Saladonic Bing Crosby, níor a cainte bé ar fap ciúl. Ach cum óin téarma sin chun chur síos ar an airnáil nua a spreagú dá bhór. Ba dhuine de bhór ailtirí cultúir na fichiúhí sé agus chruthe chuid órán íomhá déire a bhhaireann go fóil.
Look at that view, Dublin Bay.
That's nice, but really not my favourite bay, you know.
Oh?
Oh, no, you have to work west. Way west.
If you ever go across the sea to Ireland, then maybe at the closing of your day, you will sit and watch the moon rise over Clannad and see the sun go down on Galway Bay. Just to hear again.
Helion Thorpe by Hakinto. Out on the skull of Bing Crosby. The go untuk shave chinas the. Tarintuk again. Agus is doilem gur a rud éirnach a bhuintlisin. Cinte do chuig rudí aslam tírsa a bhaim ar Bing Crosby. Agus sin é cuidas na rudí nithe bhí aige agus é a cama, bhí sila chlosint. Ag is doilem go bhannig na tafadasin cinte hoi Christmas go dion an óir. Agus bheise an, agus far an a hachtach a sehe is scéal Kill Katianta on down.
And if there's gonna be a life hereafter, and somehow I feel sure there's gonna be, I will ask my God to let me make my heaven in that dear land across the Isle.